पुलिस कमिश्नर अनुराग इस वक्त वहां पर बोल रहे हैं।
टेरर अटैक्स इन दीज इंसिडेंट्स विच अकर्ड एट अराउंड 7 PM विद इन अ स्पैन ऑफ 2 hours 16 पीपल लॉस्ट देयर लाइव्स एंड 117 अदर्स वर इंजर्ड। Police had immediately swung into action and helped transfer the injured to hospitals and to organize shifting of the critically ill to other specialized hospitals. The investigation of the case has been given to SIT under the charge of our additional commissioner crime, Mr. Sandeep Shandilya. We have formed 6 specialized teams to go into the investigation. We have already started collecting material evidences and other evidences, started examining witnesses who were on the scene. The help of the forensic scientists and experts from other agencies have also been taken. Today, in fact, we had a meeting with the Honorable Chief Minister and Home Minister, along with the DG and others, and we requested for a reward, and the government has also agreed to give a reward of rupees 10 lakhs to whosoever gives credible information leading to the detection of the case. It's been a dastardly act and it has given us a resolve, it has hardened our resolve to definitely detect this case and bring the culprits to the book. We have already sounded a high alert, have started increasing the number of policemen looking into the area, checking the areas, and have also increased the number of bomb detection squads which were already in our area. We have almost doubled it from 16 to 30 with sniffer dogs. Surveillance on vulnerable areas has been increased. All the crowded markets, malls, cinema halls are also being covered. Wherever private security people are being engaged by cinema halls, malls, etc., we are trying to check their effectiveness. If they are found lacking somewhere, we definitely want to hold classes so that they come up to the mark. We are also starting an awareness campaign so that general public gets aware about the security scenario and such incidents can be prevented further. I know that no amount of explanations will be adequate to console the families of the deceased, but definitely we have been doing our best, and with all humility I'll submit that we tried our best, but as they say, the security forces have to succeed every time and a terrorist has to succeed all once. definitely we will crack this case and we will bring the culprits to the book. Okay, I know you have questions. Let me answer them. CCTV cameras, there have been a lot of speculation about that whether the CCTV cameras have been working or not. To bring you up to date on that, Hyderabad City Police had put up CCTV cameras basically for traffic management, and all of them are controlled through our control room in this building. We have a total of 303 CCTV cameras which were installed, of which 23 had become non-functional, they were removed. As on today, 265 cameras are functioning in the city and 15 are temporarily out of order. The CCTV camera which was at this spot at Dilsuknagar has been functioning till about 8:30 p.m. the day before yesterday. The speculation that somebody had cut the wires is not true. We have the footage from that camera which we are analyzing. Okay, again, as I told you, no amount of explanation will suffice, but with all my humility, I would like to explain what all we have done. First, let me explain about the alerts. 15th of November, our own intelligence department had sent a team to Delhi and they had interrogated some IM module people, and in that they had sent an extract saying that four areas, Dilsuknagar, Raniganj, Tankban, Abbots and Begum Bazaar, they were earlier recceed by those people. Now this particular module, majority of them were arrested. However, we did not take any warning lightly. I will explain the effort that we had put in detail to you. Regarding the warning which were sent, alerts that were sent recently, on 15th of February, a communication was received which said Delhi, Mumbai, Hyderabad and Bangalore, four cities, may have some retaliatory attacks. Now, again, these were promptly communicated down the line, and we had taken all precautionary measures to ensure that things do not go wrong. Now, what effort we had taken since this November thing, I would like to explain that in detail to you. We normally, actually in November was the time when we were at our maximum alert because of incidents that were happening in the old city of Hyderabad. Our entire police force was deployed, right down to the last constable. In fact, we had requisitioned forces from the Andhra Pradesh Special Police and from other branches of police so that the situation could be kept under control, and that way almost 200 pickets were deployed in those areas at that time. That was a different story. However, we were over and above that. We have been regularly conducting vehicle checks to see that people do not move with any kind of banned material or any other arms or any other thing that can damage. In the month of November, The Hyderabad City Police conducted 1,416 vehicle checks in December 1,401, in January 1,364, and in February 1,245. These are basically covering the entire city. Now let me come to the specifics of these areas which we had mentioned. We conducted specifically for terrorist threats. We have agencies in the state which basically monitor the terrorist activity. They have been specially created for this. That is our counterintelligence cell and our Octopus. We have been regularly in touch with both the agencies, and to avoid any such act, we had conducted recce and mock drills with the Octopus. In the month of November, we conducted 5 recce with Octopus. In the month of December, another 5, January 4 and February 2. We conducted 8 mock drills in December, 5 in January and 1 in February. The city police also has 16 bomb disposal squads. In view of these attacks, the bomb disposal squads are constantly deployed in vulnerable areas to cover any isolated, basically like somebody leaving an explosive laden thing or substance or a material. The total number of AS check done by BD teams in the entire Hyderabad city in November were 2,125. In December, 2,171. In January, 2,153. And in February, 1,554 different areas were covered by our PD teams. Again, we had bad experiences during Naxal attacks. The bombs were placed under the culverts at the time. So we took up culvert checking, and that we normally do. We checked 107 culverts in November, 143 in December, 75 in January, and 58 in February. Once we go to the specifics of these areas, that is Dilsukh Nagar, Abid, Stangband, Begum Bazaar, Lal Darwaza and Rani Ganj. In Dilsukh Nagar, that's a Malakpet area, in November we conducted 17 times BD checks were conducted, December 19, January 18 and February 13, a total number of 67 times we had covered that area with our bomb disposal squads for anti-sabotage check. Abids, in November 8, December 6, January 9, February 4, a total of 27 times. Tankband, 35 in November, 52 in December, 50 in January and 32, a total of 169 times in these 4 months.
हैदराबाद के पुलिस कमिश्नर अनुराग शर्मा, जिनका ये कहना था कि पुलिस को हर बार कामयाब होना होता है और आतंकवादी को सिर्फ एक बार कामयाब होना होता है। हालांकि उन्होंने तमाम जानकारियां दी कि क्या कुछ किया गया था। सुराग देने वाले को 10 लाख रुपए का इनाम दिया जाएगा, इसका उन्होंने ऐलान किया। इसके अलावा बताया कि 6 टीमें बनाई गई हैं जो इस पूरे मामले की जाँच कर रही है। हैदराबाद धमाके की जाँच SIT कर रही है। हैदराबाद में 303 CCTV लगे हुए थे, जिनमें से 23 खराब थे, उन्हें हटा दिया गया। अब 265 CCTV हैं जो लगे हुए हैं, और CCTV जो लगा हुआ था दिलसुख नगर में वो काम कर रहा था, ये कहना था पुलिस कमिश्नर का। हालांकि वो सिर्फ ट्रैफिक की व्यवस्था को देखने के लिए ही लगाया गया था।